Hey everyone, welcome to this channel. This is Sandeep Das and today I'll be discussing about AWS IAM service. Now, make sure that I'll be covering all the services. This is the first day and first day I think it's basics. It's very, very basic to understand AWS IAM service. That's why I'll be starting with IAM. Okay. Now, here you can create users, you can create roles, you can create policies, you can give identities, like you can do identity federation kind of thing. Account settings also there. Reports parts you can ignore for now, but this part, I mean this group, users, roles, policies, these are the main things, to be honest. And why you need to learn about this IAM? Because suppose you want someone else to access your account and you want to give them credentials. Now you should never share your root account credentials. Instead of that, what should you be doing? You should be creating a AWS user, that IAM user, and give that username and password to that user. You may set policies like after the login, immediately you should change the password and also enable the multi-factor authentication part, okay? I'll be showing you very slowly how it to be done. But I'm just saying you that you need to do this, okay? Now suppose for each user, I mean, you have a bunch of users, like 5 users or 10 users. Then you want them to have similar access. Then this kind you can use the group section. Like create a group and add users to the group. So whoever added to this group will have a similar access. Roles is different. Roles is support. You are giving that role to a particular service. Could be EC2, could be something else. AWS lot of services. So one service can get the role and use other services. I mean access other services in the roles part. Okay. Now see, I'm talking about the roles part. If you suppose have the AWS SDK install, I'll be showing what is AWS SDK. Just give me some time. SDK. So suppose you want to access the AWS resources using the programming language, then you can, all the services you can access in the programming language, then you need choose your programming language, whatever you need. But here also very first thing you should know about is that you need AWS CLI install, okay? So, and in AWS CLI, first thing you have to configure is the AWS secret key and the key and the secret. That too, you have to do via the IAM. Now, let me start the main part, okay? The user part. See, I have already won that if I created 44 days ago for my local MacBook. Similarly, suppose you want... Now I'm not talking about the SDK part for now. For SDK, suppose you want to have the access key ID and the secret. For that, use the programming access. But if you're just giving them the console access, not the programming access, then don't tick this one. Only tick this one. Okay. Now let's start. Suppose I want to create an IAM user for the first time. You just think about like some, could be anyone. Some guest giving is like, say Ram. Which is very like previously I used to use Ram as example, okay? So this is Ram. Now give him the AWS management access. Now you can customize the password or you can just auto generate it. I personally go with the auto generator. I don't want to use any manual one, okay? But you can use any kind of password generator site. You can do it, it's your choice. Next comes the permission part. Now see here what you see, you have the option to assign that user to particular group. I'll be just showing after this one how you can create group and assign user to that group. You can copy permission from another existing user. Suppose a local MacBook, I have the user, but suppose you have any like Rahim or could be like Monty, whoever the name is, you have given a particular access to him and similar access you want in this particular user also. You can do that. You can just copy from that particular access to this one, or AWS have managed policies. Okay. That means if you just click, I'm showing you the administrator one. Suppose I'm giving the administrator one. It's loading. Give it some time because all the services are like here. Now, policy summary, you can see account, Alexa, app mesh, all the services that AWS have, all those kind of services are full access is granted for this particular policy. Now, you might not need all the policies, right? I mean, suppose you just want them to have EC2 access, or suppose Lambda access, then you don't need to provide all the access to them. I mean, anyone can misuse it. You never know actually, to be honest. So suppose a particular user want the easy to access, then just filter like this one. Just go have a, here is a search portion here. Click on whatever service you want to give the access, you can do. Now I can give them like EC2 container registry, that ECR, not EC2. This is EC2 full access, like that. Or there is an EC2 read only access. Now what are the differences? I mean, EC2 full access means you can just go ahead and see here. That is CloudWatch. If you give them the EC2 full access, of course CloudWatch for the metrics purpose, they also need the EC2 console. I mean, whatever option you should have, they will see it is auto scaling, ELB, ELB version 2, IAM. So they have this, all these access. Okay. IAM is not the complete one, but limited to that one. Okay. So, but you don't need that. I mean, suppose you just want them to have EC2 read only access. I mean, they can just go, suppose a reviewer, they want to see that how many EC2 instances your team is running. Could be just you might want an account that just to check that how many the instances are running. It could be anyone. Okay, those cases also just give the read access where they don't need to make anything, just to review purpose or the counting, whatever the purpose is. You don't want them to change anything or make any terminate it or do, can you should not allow, not allow them to do anything. Those kind of cases it is needed. Okay. Again, if you just need to give them the full access like this, you can do. Then go to tags. Suppose you have created a user. Now, for you can use particular tag to multiple things. When I show that detailed overview on tag, I will show you. Just to make sure that suppose who what department it is. Just a common example. Like this user could be normal like development department. So say department. This is very good when you filter them by these values. Like for this development department, I have 10 users. Out of the 10 users, I've given access them to the EC2 or given to the Lambda. This kind of thing you can do. So I'm giving value department, suppose development, dev, or just say dev for now. Okay. You can review, click on user. And you'll see, is getting created. Yeah. And now the login part. So whoever the person is, they have to log in. So here you can just do this. And suppose I'm just giving you an example. Okay, what I can give a incognito mode. And I will just copy this, Ram is the username. Let it load. And the password is the password that is generated. Okay. Now the password is password, sign in. Okay, and see, since I have made a policy to change the, I must change this password, okay? I have said like that one. There's an option that user must change the password while creating one. That's why it's asking to change that one. Old password, just copy the old password. And then we'll just change the password. And I will show you how this works. Old password, new password. Let me just go to password generator. Strong another password generator. This is just for example, I'm showing. You can set any kind of password. You don't have to follow my steps. Okay. Okay, now let me change the password. Let's reset the password again. And then now I want to show you what it actually does. See, I have given them only EC2 full access, not other services. Now if I try and go to do other things, you will see I should not be able to do it. Now if you go to AC2, so I think I have two or three instances running. I mean, I just stopped, it might be. If I go to running instances, I think it will not show. Let's go instances, just normal instances. Okay, I don't have any instance running, but I can just go ahead and launch any kind of instances if I really want it. But I can access it, like I can access all these kind of things. Okay. Now If I suppose I want to access the lambda, just for example, I'm showing a lambda or IDS, whatever you want. If I try to access this, then what happens? See, you are not authorized to perform it, because since I have not given permission to this particular account to access lambda, that's why you're not able to access this. So AWS have the policy is like deny all access by default until unless you explicitly say that these users should have this permission. Okay, even so, suppose you have given them the EC2 full access, but still you want some services that users should not able to access, you can do the permission boundary that I may show in the advanced sessions, not this session, but think that exists. And if you really need it, you can search about it and get it done. Okay. So till now I talked about how you can utilize the management using the AWS user part. Now let's think about it. Like, it's not about just, you know, every time you cannot do managed everything using the, you know, UI. You want to access your services using the programming languages. And to do that, you need the programming key. I mean, for the programming, you need the key and the secret. How to do it? Let's go. Let me show you. Okay. This is the one. Not just the, not just about the UI, I mean, AWS CLI, but any SDK, if you want to utilize any SDK, in the video, I've already shown where to find it, how to find the SDKs. They give the name, like, suppose I'm creating the Node.js, I have a Node.js application, and for the application, I need to access some AWS services. Could be like, like suppose sending notifications or sending the SMS. For that, I need, just for example, I'm saying I want to send a notification. How to create for that account? Okay. Okay, for that I need to give like SMS sender sending access node app. Okay, I just want to give this particular only the access key and the secret key. Other, just saying AWS API, CLI, SDK, and other development tools, you need to give the access key and I. Okay, next permission here. Just give them the SNS access, nothing else. I'm giving full SNS access. Now tags, like say app, give the app name, node app, review it, and done. That's it. Go to the IAM service. Suppose I have created this user. Right now I have two users, then previously the old one and this is the new one. Now here, this is the user part. You already saw, right, how I did it. You just use the login URL that is given when creating the account, and then the user, just give them the username and password, and they will log in and do all this kind of stuff. And so what is group? Now see, I have explicitly managing that particular users in policy, access policy, to have this EC2. What if I give the access to a group and add a user to the group? That user should have the access. Let me show you that way. Okay, let's say group name is demo group. I mean, this is a demo only, right? Next step. Okay, policy access. I just want them again EC2. It could be anything. I'm just giving them the EC2. Okay, EC2 full access. Next stop. Get group. Now let's get another user and call it Rahim. And let's give them the AWS management console. See, here's the option I told you, that's why they asked me to change the password for that user. So do it. Let's go to permissions. I'm not giving any permission. Okay, I'm just assigning them to the demo. I mean, that user to demo group. Still, this user will have the access for the EC2 access, since I just allow it. Actually, let's, like, without assigning, you can do this for the assigning, and then I'll just not do it. Say department. Department, say dev, review, then create user. See, permission boundary not set because I didn't set any. Again, let's do another incognito. Okay, and there I don't need that password to be pasted anymore. So see, this is the URL again. Copy the URL, it could be different for you, it will be different for you, not could be, okay. And then just go to the account, new tab, is the okay, incognito mode, let it load. Okay, let's load it. Now let's Rahim, actually Rahim, I can just type it down, and this is a password. Say Rahim, the password, and login. See, it will again ask me to change the password. I have the password copied anyway. New password, I can say anything. Okay, so change the password. So I wanted to show you that if I remove after this, like you will see that this Rahim also we did not mention directly, but still since we added to the group, it should have the easy to access. It should, of course. See, you have the access, the easy to keep your security group and blah blah blah. So you have the access. Now if we go to the again for this user also, if we go to the any service, now I'm saying Lambda obviously, but so go show to S3. Let's give you an example. This user should not have access to S3. See, access denied, isn't it? That's what I'm saying. Now let's go to okay, they have the access. Now what if I go to previous screen and let's go to IM again in the root account. And what if I remove that users from this group? I mean, we have this group where I've added this user, and let's remove the user again. Remove users from the group. Okay, this is Rahim. I'm just removing him. And remove the user. Done. Now I remove the user. This group, if I go to that previous screen where Rahim was logged in state, now if I go to EC2. See, this user should not have the EC2 access. Let's do refresh, maybe, okay, launch instance. Let's see if we can able to access or not. I don't think it should be able to access. Okay. Describe having. It's not allowing. It will never allow it. Because that user don't have that EC2 access anymore. I remove from the group, isn't it? That's what I want to show you. Maybe you can... So yeah, see nothing is showing, no data is showing because don't have the access. So how it will show? See error, you are not authorized to perform this operation. So this is what I need to show. Now what if actually yeah, that's what it is. Now if suppose you remove that Rahim from the, I mean from the like completely removing it, what will happen? Done. Now let's go back to the screen where we have the login state. So this is like this. Now what if we just refresh the screen again? You will be asked to log out. See, this has got logged out. This is what I already show you. Let's stop this, close this one. Okay, this is about groups and users. Okay, now what about the roles? I mean ultimately roles have some use cases, otherwise how? Suppose where you can give the roles, let me try that one. Okay, this is the roles part. So you can give create a role for, I mean what is the use case? Common use case is EC2, like allow EC2 to call other AWS services, just like they're saying, or Lambda, like allow Lambda function to call any other AWS services on your behalf from using the APIs if you want, or direct access also available. Or select service views use cases. Suppose you want to use code deploy, like code deploy, allow code deploy to call other services, code deploy ECS, allow code deploy to read S3 objects, invoke Lambda function, publish to SNS topics, all this. This is about your use cases. Now, another account. So this is called identity role switching. So you can give the role to other AWS account. Here, you just have to mention that other account ID. And this is I think required MFA, you should do it. Required external IT best practices on a third party to Azure role. So this is Azure role function. It's up to you. You can give access to a particular user, and that user can access your account as a particular role to access your, I mean, your account services. The billing will happen on your account if they use your account resources. Okay, make sure of that in mind. This is OAuth using Cognito. You can do it. SAML. Suppose you want to do identity federation. Like you have a company, you have your company own database management, and that management, that you have the user list and all, they have their own username password. You can like map their access here. Okay, I'll be not going to deep, but you can do it. You should know that that option is there. You can later on explore more, or maybe in the later videos when I discuss under this kind of things, you'll be able to learn it. Okay, let's go back to the IAM again. So this is about roles. Now what about the policies? Like, see, AWS have the managed policies, but like you might not always need a managed policy. I mean, you should not always depend on a managed policy. You need a very customized policy where you can find like this user can have EC2 access to particular particular EC2 ID, or kind of in S3 bucket, that user should have a particular S3 bucket. Those kind of use cases I can achieve by the inline policy also. I'll show how to the inline policy, or for this cases, I mean, you can get customized your customized policy and do it. Just create a policy. Now here, see, there is a visual editor available. You can utilize it. It's perfectly fine with it. Like choose a service. It's actually easy that way. Say I want to give a S3 access. And now in S3 access, what kind of access you want to give? You can give the list access, read access, tagging access, write access, permission management. It's up to you. Just see the list access or all. If you suppose select all the access you want to give, you can do like this. It's a policy designer kind of thing. Request condition. You can specify the condition here. Let's see. So MFA required. Suppose you want to make sure that any deletion happen or addition happen, MFA is needed, then you can do like MFA required. Source IP. Then you can mention only operation can happen on a particular IP source. You can do like that way. If you go to JSON, I think they are not allowing. But if you just do it, go to review policy, then you required to, I don't know, because I'm not giving any access. Okay, now review the policy. It will generate a JSON policy for us. Okay, what happening? Just a moment. Four warnings, specify, okay. Specify all users. So, yeah, this is also important. Like, what is the particular resource you want to give the IAM access? As I'm saying, AWS have the policy to deny all access by default. So you have to explicitly do it. Since I'm just demo, you can fine grade in. I mean, see, you can just give this ARN to fine grade in, fine grade that thing. Just any bucket, that means any bucket. Access point to any access point. This is up to you. Or you can mention what is the particular point you want to make sure. I mean, want to give. You can mention the region name and the access point name. Similarly, you can give the buckets ARN here. Sorry, bucket name here. Okay. Now, if you just want to give them the S3 or maybe some other bunch of services, you can do that way. Okay. Now, review the policy. You will see they will generate. Okay. Give them the policy name like S3 access policy. The solution is up to you. S3 access policy. Policy, okay. Now create the policy. I'll see policies ultimately. This will S3 policy. This is a custom. See, if it's AWS provided, you have this icon here, and of course, you'll understand. If it's your service that you see, it's a customer managed, they're saying a customer managed, and if AWS managing it, there in the type you can see it's AWS managed services. Okay, now click on S3 service policy. Okay, and here if you click on the JSON part, you will see the JSON representation of the policy, which is very important. What you can do, you can always come here like this, and you can click on the JSON. You should practice the JSON one, because in most of the certification cases, you will not have the editor kind of UI. They will say kind of like what this JSON IAM policy mean. Those cases, you should know about how to use the policy in JSON format. Otherwise, you'll be not able to answer those. So make sure that you learn the policy language, AWS policy, this one, policy language here, okay? It's ultimately JSON and nothing else. Okay, import manage policy. Now I'm going to show you the manage policy part. So go to the users, click on any user. There is an inline policy. If you come here, is a thing called, suppose it has EC2 access, it has IAM user access. Now you want to give them the any particular other service access. Suppose I want to give them the Lambda access. So I can again, you can come like this. If you click on go, JSON nothing is there. Since it's like inline policies, also like additional policy access you have to give into this particular IAM user. Choose service, I'm giving that to the Lambda. You could give any kind of access. Now in Lambda, what? I'm giving full access. Specify windows, I'm giving all resources. You can find them everything up to you. Okay. Now review policy. Give this like inline policy. Like RAM inline policy. It's up to you. Inline RAM Lambda access. That's it. Give the policy. And it's inline. Now, why inline is different from this one? You are just might be wondering why it is. So this is Lambda access. Now go to the policies and search by the policy. It's not there because it's custom policy, an inline policy, particular that to users. You are not creating the policy separately. Or if you suppose thinking that I'm creating there, that means coming will, no, it will not happen like that. Inline mean inline to the particular user. If it's the managed one, that is managed by you separately as policies. Okay, that is a different. Oh, I hope that I will do make you understand that part. AWS all kind of managed policies. API gateway, this is for RDS, it's for the like EC2 or maybe administrator. If you select the administrator access, all the access should be there. Okay, except the billing. For billing, you need to do something more. Then we'll be able to, later session also, not for this one, but you have all this kind of access. So just see, and suppose you are going to give some access to a particular user, make sure what that particular user need, only give that particular, not everything. Okay, so I hope I will do explain as simply as possible the groups, the users and the roles. If you still have any questions you have in your mind, simply let me know in the comments. Also, before leaving, make sure to subscribe the channel and like this video and share it with others. Oh yeah, don't forget to click on the bell icon. Bye bye.